everyone, am I visible, audible? Give me a thumbs up in the chat box fast so I can start the lecture ahead. Are you people there? Give me a thumbs up in the chat box fast. Okay, thanks for confirming. So I welcome you all for this session also. This is the third session for today. We have studied microbiology, DNA viruses we have completed today. In the pharmacology, we have just completed ATT. Dots are still remaining. We will continue it tomorrow. And now we are starting with pathology. In pathology, we will continue with anemias. So yesterday we have already started with anemia. So without wasting time, I'm just starting it. So you can see yesterday we have started with anemia. In anemias, we have seen this classification. So why anemia occur? So this is the etiological classification of anemias. Anemias, we have two type of classification, morphological classification and etiological classification. Morphological classification, there are three types of anemia, normocytic and normochromic. The size and color both is normal, normocytic, normochromic, microcytic and hypochromic. So the size and color both are less. And the third is macrocytic and normochromic. Here the size is less but color is normal. So first thing indicates size of RBC. Second thing is color of RBC, that is hemoglobin. So here size and color both are normal. Here size and color both are less. Here size is less but color is normal. So the three types of anemia: normocytic, normochromic, microcytic, hypochromic, macrocytic, normochromic. Yesterday we have seen the mnemonics which anemia come under which category. So normocytic, normochromic, microcytic, hypochromic, there were four anemia, SITA, SITA, you know, sideroblastic, iron deficiency, thalassemia and anemia of chronic disease. So we have started with that. We have started with iron deficiency anemia. Rest of the anemias we will see today. So I will continue anemias. So can you see anemias? So anemia can be, this is a geological classification. It can be due to three reasons. Anemia can occur due to three reasons. Either due to blood loss, suddenly if the person is having accident, so blood loss is there, patient is anemic. After surgery, patient is anemic. So blood loss can be acute, can be chronic, like an accident, like a surgery, it is acute. Chronic is peptic ulcer, hematuria, hematemesis, hemorrhoids, that can be chronic, daily small blood loss. That is chronic, acute and chronic. Now the second cause of anemia is decreased production of RBC. Or the third is increased destruction of RBC. So increased destruction of RBC is known as hemolytic anemias. That I will teach you tomorrow. The most important lecture is going to be tomorrow, hemolytic anemias. 1 hour lecture, I will cover seven anemias in that. The seven important hemolytic anemias which I will cover in a comparative table tomorrow. Today I am covering this decreased production wale all anemias. Now decreased production is there. So decreased production kyun hai? Decreased production, either the defect is in the cytoplasm of the precursor of RBC, or the defect is in the nucleus of the precursor of the RBC, or the defect is in the stem cell, hematopoietic stem cell. So cytoplasm contains hemoglobin. This is cytoplasm, this is nucleus. We know cytoplasm contains hemoglobin. So defect in cytoplasm means defect in hemoglobin. So defect in hemoglobin, defect is in heme or globin. If it is in heme, there are three anemias: iron deficiency anemia, sideroblastic anemia, anemia of chronic disease. If defect is in globin, it is thalassemia. If nucleus defect, is megaloblastic, and stem cell production with aplastic and PERCA. So from these anemias, yesterday we have completed one anemia, iron deficiency anemia. Rest of the anemias I am going to cover tomorrow. So I will start with sideroblastic. Immediately after that, I will come on ECD, anemia of chronic disease. Then I will come on megaloblastic anemia. Then I will come on aplastic anemia. Then I will come on PERCA. Thalassemia, I will cover it in hemolytic anemia. Thalassemia is common here also and hemolytic also. So thalassemia I will cover tomorrow. Have you got my plan of action? What I have covered yesterday, what I am covering today, what I am covering tomorrow. So in three lectures anemia will be over. So tomorrow I will cover all hemolytic anemias including thalassemia. Done. So today decreased production wale will be covered. Decreased production can be due to three causes: either cytoplasmic defect, or nucleus may defect, or stem cell may defect. So cytoplasmic defect means hemoglobin may defect. So defect in heme or defect in globin. Heme may defect hai. So heme kyun nahi ban raha? Iron deficiency anemia hai, or sideroblastic anemia, or anemia of chronic disease. And globin may defect hai, to thalassemia. So SITA ho jayega. S-I-T-A. S-I-T-A. From SITA, yesterday we covered I. Iron deficiency anemia. Rest of them we will cover it today. Nucleus nahi ban raha. Nucleus is made up of DNA. So there is defect in DNA. So there is defect in megaloblastic anemia. So megaloblastic anemia, because DNA is made up of folic acid and B12 or folic acid ki deficiency se DNA nahi banega, so there will be megaloblastic anemia. I will teach you this also. And stem cell mein problem hai, to overall hematopoietic stem cell mein problem hai, तो ऑल पैनसाइटोपेनिया होगा, ना आरबीसी बनेगा ना डब्ल्यूबीसी ना प्लेटलेट, सो इट इज नोन एज एप्लास्टिक एनीमिया. और सिर्फ आरबीसी के प्रिकर्सर में प्रॉब्लम है, आरबीसी के स्टेम सेल में प्रॉब्लम है, तो सिर्फ आरबीसी नहीं बनेगा, पेशेंट विल हैव एनीमिया बट नॉट थ्रोम्बोसाइटोपेनिया और ल्यूकोपेनिया. सो दैट एनीमिया इज नोन एज पर्का, प्योर रेड सेल एप्लेशिया, ओनली रेड सेल एप्लेशिया. So I will teach you these both also. So let me start. Sita ka I ho gaya tha. So I'm not revising you iron deficiency anemia. I'm starting with sideroblastic anemia. Give me a thumbs up. I'm starting with sideroblastic anemia. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Have you got it? Till now, that was the orientation ki hum kahan hai, kya kar rahe hai. So I'm starting with sideroblastic anemia. Now, sideroblastic anemia. You all can understand what is sideroblastic anemia if you can understand this diagram. Give me a thumbs up if you can understand this diagram. Those who are my old student, they know what is diagram. What is this diagram? Those who have attended my yesterday's lecture. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Those who can understand this diagram. This is iron metabolism. Okay, listen. I'm eating iron. This is my diagram. So suppose I'm eating iron by mouth. So iron is going inside the mouth, inside the esophagus, inside the stomach. In the stomach, from ferric form, it is get converted into ferric form by HCl in the stomach. And this ferrous form is absorbed in the intestinal cell. This is a cell in intestine. So by DMT transporter, it is absorbed inside the cell. After reaching inside the cell of the intestine, it goes in the blood on the other side. So another transporter is required. The name of the transporter is ferroportin, FP, ferroportin. It will reach in the blood. In the blood, again, it will get transferred into the converted into the ferric form. So jo hum khate hain wo bhi ferric hota hai, or in the blood ultimately it is ferric. For absorption purpose it get converted into ferrous. So again it is ferric form. It will sit on its transporter, its car, its auto rickshaw, its vehicle. The name of the transporter is transferrin. So iron is moving on the transporter in the blood here and there. And from the blood it is going to all the organs. The organ which require iron is bone marrow. This is a bone marrow. In the bone marrow, these are the precursors. You know, this is hematopoietic stem cell. This is early normoblast, intermediate normoblast, late normoblast, reticulocyte. They will take iron. All of them will listen. All of them will take iron and utilize this iron in the formation of heme, of hemoglobin. Why iron is required? Iron is required for the synthesis of heme. Heme banega hemoglobin. Done. So iron is utilized here. And extra iron is carried in the liver and liver will store it in the form of the ferritin. We know the story. Now listen, what is the problem in sideroblastic anemia? What was the problem in IDA? Iron deficiency anemia with problem kya thi? Person was not eating iron, or if he is eating iron, it is not absorbing well. Either the dietary deficiency or absorption problem. So iron hi kam hai. Iron hi kam hai. Yahan pe iron kam nahi hai. Sideroblastic anemia mein iron bharpoor hai. Abundant iron is there. Patient is eating lots of iron. Absorption is also good. All the iron is reaching in blood. All the iron is reaching in blood. So what is the problem now? You will ask me, ma'am, what is the problem then? All the iron is present in blood. It is coming in bone marrow. In the bone marrow, these are the cells. These are the cells. They will take the iron. The precursor cell will take the iron. So this is the precursor cell. These all are precursor cells in the bone marrow. They all will take the iron. They all will take the iron for converting iron into heme and formation of hemoglobin of the heme. They will take the iron. How iron gets converted into heme? You tell me inside the cell. It takes place in mitochondria of these cells. So these all cells have mitochondria. This is the mitochondria. So inside all the mitochondria of these precursor cells, inside the mitochondria of them, this iron get converted into heme. This iron get converted. This is no, you have studied in biochemistry how iron get converted into heme. Iron got converted into heme. So for this, enzymes are required. The most important enzyme here is ALA. ALA. You know ALA. Aminolevulinic synthetase, ALA synthetase. So that enzyme is required. Now that is defective. That is defective. Iron is abundant. Patient is eating abundant iron in diet. Absorption is also normal. So all the iron I am eating, it is getting absorbed from the intestine. It is reaching in my blood. From the blood, it is going to the bone marrow. In the bone marrow, the precursors are present. These are the precursors. They will pick iron inside their cytoplasm. So all the iron is present in the cytoplasm of these cells, but they are unable to convert iron into hemoglobin. So iron is present, but hemoglobin is not formed. Again, I am saying, iron is present, but hemoglobin is not formed. So all the iron is accumulated here in the cytoplasm only. In the cytoplasm, you can see red color, blue color dots are present, which are iron dots. So the precursors also contain dot, dot, dot iron in the cytoplasm. So these are known as sideroblast. These all precursors, early normoblast, intermediate normoblast, and late normoblast, all of them are known as sideroblast because they contain abundant of iron in the cytoplasm. They are unable to convert the iron into hemoglobin. So iron is accumulated in the cytoplasm. So RBCs are formed from this defective normoblast. RBCs are formed. That RBC will come in the blood. RBC also contain dot 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 iron. Such RBC is known as siderocyte. Siderocyte. So sideroblast and siderocyte are seen. Siderocyte are the precursors which have iron in the cytoplasm, and siderocyte is the RBC which has iron in the cytoplasm. The defect is in the mitochondrial enzyme which converts iron into hemoglobin. Give me a thumbs up. So iron is present, but it cannot be utilized. So problem is in utilization. Problem is not in the iron. Iron is abundant. Iron deficiency mein iron hi nahi kha raha, yahan pe iron khoob hai. I'm eating abundant of iron in my diet. I'm taking iron supplement also. Absorption is also very good. All the iron is present in my blood. So blood is going to the bone marrow. Bone marrow mein the cells are taking the iron but unable to convert it. So next time iron yahan jayega to they will not take. They will say already we are having. We do not need more. Hum to zero convert nahi kar pa rahe. We do not need more. So all the iron will be stored in the form of the ferritin. All the iron will be stored in the muscle. So ferritin increases too much. So in this anemia, in contrast to iron deficiency anemia, ferritin is abundant. Iron deficiency anemia mein ferritin was less. Here ferritin was the most sensitive indicator, the earliest indicator which falls. Here ferritin is abundant. Ferritin is abundant. Still hemoglobin is less. Give me a thumbs up. I really tried. It was the most complicated portion. Why patient is having in sideroblastic anemia? Ferritin is high. Still hemoglobin is low. Patient, students do not understand this. I really tried hard. Everyone give me a thumbs up if you got it. Everyone give me a thumbs up if you got it. Everyone. You have to give me 1 minute. I have to rub it and tell you one more thing here. So that's why. Just give me 1 minute. One more minute. Okay. So you can see the entire diagram is in front of you. What is the problem in sideroblastic anemia? I hope you got it. What is sideroblast? You got it. What is siderocyte? You got it. Yes or no? Any problem in understanding it? Anyone? Listen. I will tell you once more. One more thing I would like to tell you here. So this is the iron patient is eating. I'm telling you sideroblastic anemia pathophysiology, what I want to say here. So patient is eating iron. So iron is abundant in diet. All the iron patient is eating, it will be absorbed. It will be absorbed. It will reach in the blood. It will sit on its transporter transferrin. So it will be carried. Absorption. Diet is also good. Supply of iron is also good. Absorption of iron is also good. All the iron transporter is also good. It is carrying to the bone marrow. In the bone marrow, these are the precursors. This is early normoblast, intermediate normoblast, late on. They will take iron and try to convert it into hemoglobin. So for conversion of iron into hemoglobin inside this cell, in the mitochondria of this cell, these cells, mitochondria, one enzyme is required. The name of the enzyme is ALA, alanine. I'm telling you the full form of ALA. You know the full form of ALA, no? This is ALA. You know, it is ALA synthetase. It is this amino luminal synthetase. So this is the enzyme. ALA is deficient. So since ALA is deficient, iron is present, but it cannot be utilized for the formation of heme. So because the enzyme for conversion is defective. So all these cells, let me form a bone marrow for you. This is a bone marrow. Inside the bone marrow, these are the precursor cells. Let me draw, this is a precursor cell. So this is the nucleus of the precursor cell. It is taking iron in the cytoplasm, but it is unable to convert it into hemoglobin. So iron will be accumulated in the cytoplasm in the form of blue colored dots. So this cell is not known as normoblast. It is not known as normoblast now. It is known as sideroblast. So sideroblast is a normoblast in the bone marrow, which contains abundant of iron in the cytoplasm. Give me a thumbs up. Now this normoblast or sideroblast will convert into early, intermediate, late, reticulocyte. Ultimately, RBC is formed. And this RBC will come in the blood. This RBC also contains abundant of iron in the cytoplasm. So such RBC is known as siderocyte. Erythrocyte, nahin. We will not say it erythrocyte. We will say it siderocyte. So instead of normoblast, we use the term sideroblast. And instead of erythrocyte, we use the term siderocyte. So sideroblast and sideroblast are the cells which contain abundant of iron in the cytoplasm. Why they contain abundant of iron in the cytoplasm? Because inside in their mitochondria, ALA is absent. So they cannot convert iron into hemoglobin. So iron is present, but it cannot be utilized for conversion of hemoglobin. Give me a thumbs up. So all the iron here, bone marrow will not take more iron from the blood. वो कहेगा भाई मेरे पास already बहुत है मुझे नहीं चाहिए. I don't need more iron. I'm already having sufficient abundant of iron in the cytoplasm and I'm unable to convert it into hemoglobin. So all the iron will be transmitted to the liver. So all the iron will be transmitted to the liver. So ferritin increases abundantly in contrast to iron deficiency anemia. So if you take the blood of these patients, they will have less hemoglobin. Hemoglobin they will have less. But if you check ferritin in their blood, ferritin is abundant. In contrast to iron deficiency anemia, in which hemoglobin and ferritin both were less. Rather, in iron deficiency anemia, ferritin was the earliest indicator or most sensitive indicator which falls before hemoglobin. So that is the contrasting feature. Both patients come to you. This is IDA patient, this is sideroblastic anemia patient. Both are coming to my clinic and saying, Doctor, I'm having fatigue, I'm having weakness. I have done CBC for both of them. Both of them having hemoglobin 7. Both of them are severe anemic. That's why both of them are present with fatigue. So looking only at hemoglobin, I cannot decide whether the patient is sideroblastic or iron deficiency anemia. I will ask both of them to do one more blood test, do ferritin in the iron. So both of them are coming with their report, one ferritin less, one ferritin more. Hemoglobin, both of them is less. Ferritin less one, hemoglobin also less. That is iron deficiency anemia, ferritin more, but hemoglobin less. That is sideroblastic anemia. Treatment for both of them is different. For iron deficiency anemia, I will offer iron supplement, either oral or parenteral. Yahan to iron already excess hai, iron thodi dungi. Yahan pe to already excess hai, toxicity ho jayegi. I will not offer iron. Yahan pe to already excess mein hai iron. I will not offer iron to such patients. I will treat the cause. If it is genetic, nothing can be done. Blood transfusion will be done. If it is acquired, I will treat the cause. Have you got it? Give me a thumbs up every month. That's why being a doctor, diagnosis is important. Patients ka complaint ek hi hoga, weakness, fatigue. Done. But being a doctor, hemoglobin will be less, of course. So looking at CBC, you cannot decide the type of anemia. Both of them are hemoglobin less. Both of them are MCV less. Both of them are MCH less. Both the anemias are microcytic, hypochromic. But Sita mein se S hai ki I hai. What it is. For that, ferritin is a deciding factor. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Everyone, fast. I tried hard. Done. So, sideroblastic anemia. So, here the problem, the body has adequate amount of iron. But the problem, the body is unable to incorporate it into hemoglobin. Because that's why the excessive iron gets accumulated in the normoblast, known as sideroblast, and in the erythrocyte, known as sidrocyte. They have cytoplasmic granules of the iron. Excess iron is accumulated in the form of the granules. As I have told you, excessive iron is accumulated in the form of the granules here in this normoblast. In this normoblast, and such normoblasts are known as sideroblast. So sideroblasts are of three types: type 1, type 2, type 3. Listen, type 1, type 2, type 3. See this three diagram. So these are the three normoblasts present in the bone marrow. They took iron from the blood and tried to convert it into hemoglobin, but they are unable to do so. So iron get accumulated in their cytoplasm. If less than 5 granules of iron is present in the cytoplasm, it is known as type 1 and it is normal. It is present maybe inside my bone marrow. If you check yours also, it is normal. So 2-3 granules are present in our normoblast, early, intermediate, late normoblast. All of us having this type 1 sideroblast is normal. Then type 2, more than 5 granules are present, but they are present haphazard anywhere in the cytoplasm. More than five. It is present in excess iron. If I eat excess of iron, or if I give iron injection to myself, if I take iron tablet daily, so I will have this type of, if you check my bone marrow, so this will be the presentation. But type 3, having more than 5, yahan pe bhi more than 5 the, yahan bhi more than 5 the. But see the arrangement. The granules are arranged perinuclear. They are arranged perinuclear, forming a circle, at least more than 1/3 of the circumference of the nucleus. Perinuclear arrangement. Typical, this is type 3. This is seen in sideroblastic anemia. So in sideroblastic anemia, type 3 sideroblasts are seen. You should know the three types of sideroblast. Actually, sideroblasts are normoblasts. Ye normoblast hai, ye bone, ye tino hai kya? Type 1, type 2, type 3 are B cells, the intermediate cells. Early normoblast, intermediate normoblast, late normoblast. All of them are taking iron from the blood, and the iron is present in the form of the granules in their cytoplasm. So if less than 5 granules are present, it is normal. It is known as type 1. If more than 5 are present, but arranged haphazardly, sometimes today I have eaten spinach, today I have eaten red meat, or today I have eaten jaggery, or today I have eaten an iron tablet. So any iron supplement I have eaten in excess. So after a day or two, you can find these type inside my blood. So it is also normal. It is seen in excess iron sometimes. but type 3 is abnormal. If you're finding type 3 sideroblast in someone's bone marrow, the patient is having sideroblastic anemia. Type 3 is more than 5, but see, the arrangement is typical perinuclear in the form of the circle, at least more than 1/3 of the circumference. Everyone give me a thumbs up. I again tried hard. So these are the three types of sideroblast: less than 5, more than 5 but not perinuclear, more than 5 but perinuclear. Type 3 are known as ring sideroblast. Type 3 are known as ring sideroblast, and these are the hallmark of sideroblastic anemia. Give me a thumbs up. That is the thing. Have you got it? So what is the problem? Again, you can see here type 1, 2, 3. You can see this is type 1, this is type 2, this is type 3. Type 3 is known as ring. Everyone give me a thumbs up. And this is the pearl stain or Prussian blue. One and the same thing. Pearl stain or Prussian blue, you can see, of bone marrow. So the blue color thing is the iron. Can you see the blue thing here? So see, iron blue dots are more. So that is iron is more. And can you see all of them are ring sideroblast? I will zoom it out for you. So if you take bone marrow of such patient, just suppose I am the patient, you take my bone marrow, you do a pearl stain on the bone marrow, you will find this scenario. You can see all of them are ring sideroblast. See, all of them are ring sideroblast. Most of them are ring sideroblast. Give me a thumbs up. So this is a ring sideroblast. This is a look at the arrows. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So have you got it? What is the etiology? Have you got it? Now the problem is that, the question is that, why these patients are unable to convert iron into hemoglobin? Why they are unable? They are unable to convert iron into hemoglobin in the precursors. Why they are? Now there are two reasons: hereditary and acquired. If you say hereditary, ALA is absent. God has not given ALA to them. ALA enzyme is required. The full form of ALA, you know, it is aminolevulonic acid synthetase. ALA is absent in them. Can you see ALA here? Let me search for ALA. I can't find ALA in that, but somewhere ALA is required here in this step, I guess. So ultimately, iron cannot get converted into hemoglobin. You know all these steps you have studied in your biochemistry. I'm not repeating it. So ALA is absent. So iron is present, but it cannot be converted into hemoglobin. So mitochondria is defective. That is hereditary. Acquired causes are more important. If you talk about acquired causes, so in acquired causes, the drugs are important. There are some drugs. If the patient is having tuberculosis, so patient will take INH, not isoniazid. For the treatment of tuberculosis, isoniazid or lead or chloramphenicol or penicillamine or alcohol or deficiency of pyridoxine. You know, INH causes the deficiency of pyridoxine. These all things causes temporary suppression of ALA. It is not permanent hereditary congenital absence of ALA. They all causes temporary suppression of ALA. And if you remove the culprit, if you stop the treatment of these drugs, again, ALA will be synthesized and sideroblastic anemia can be cured. So you have to see the patient of sideroblastic anemia, you have to see whether it is hereditary or whether it is acquired. If it is hereditary, now nothing can be done. Only blood transfusion is the option. God has not given the enzyme, then how you will give it? And if it is acquired, now remove the cause, remove the offending agent, then ALA will be synthesized and sideroblastic anemia will be cured by itself. Give me a thumbs up. So these are the acquired causes. Hereditary to ho gaya. It is X-linked dominant autosomal recessive, autosomal dominant disease. Sare presentation ho sakte hain. And acquired with drugs are important. Chemotherapy is also there. Radiotherapy is also there. But drugs are there. You should know the drugs. Give me a thumbs up. Have you learned the name of the drugs? It is lead. It is INH, chloramphenicol, penicillinase, alcohol, and deficiency of vitamin B6 pyridoxine. So that is the thing, because MCQs are based on it. So clinical features are same. Clinical features, patient will present with fatigue, GA, bone, non-specific complaints. Lab diagnosis. Who will tell me lab diagnosis? Lab diagnosis of all anemias. This is my classical master chart. So all anemias, you have to stay here also. Here only. So yesterday we have discussed iron deficiency anemia. Who will tell me iron deficiency anemia? Pehle isko iron deficiency anemia ke liye fill karte hain. Then we will fill it for sideroblastic anemia. Then we will compare it. Chalo, pehle IDA ke liye batao. Who will tell me IDA? Hemoglobin will less. That's why anemia. Sare anemia mein hemoglobin to less ho gai. RBC to less hoongai. Retic count is also less here. All indices, MCV, MCH, and MCHC, they will fall because we are studying microcytic hypochromic anemia, CETA. So, ye all will fall. WBC will be normal, platelet will be normal. WBC and platelet will be abnormal in aplastic anemia, jahan pe pancytopenia hoga, yahan pe megaloblastic anemia, yahan pe to normal hogi. I am talking about IDA. Bone marrow mein cellularity will increase to compensate because patient is having anemia, na? For compensatory mechanism, it will increase. Erythropoiesis, of cellularity, bone marrow mein, there are two, three things. Erythropoiesis, that is RBC formation. thrombophlebitis, that is platelet formation, and leukophlebitis, matlab WBC formation. Patient is having anemia, na? So tino arm mein se erythropoiesis zyada hoga. Erythropoiesis zyada hoga, that's why ME ratio will decrease. Myeloid kam hoga, erythroid zyada hoga. Numerator kam hoga, denominator zyada hoga. So that's why the ratio will decrease. Lung, ME ratio will decrease in these anemias. Done. And marrow iron, yeah, that is the thing. So here, in iron deficiency anemia, the marrow iron was less. Marrow mein the precursors was taking the iron, but iron hai kam na, diet mein iron kam hai. So it was less. Biochemistry mein, blood mein iron is less. Serum mein ferritin is less. TIBC or transferrin saturation, yesterday I told you. So khali riksha or bhara hua riksha, yesterday I taught you. So khali one is TIBC. TIBC increases in iron deficiency anemia and saturation decreases. Now fill the whole table with sideroblastic anemia. Who will help me in filling? Who will help me? So I will use different color. So tell me hemoglobin. Start from here for sideroblastic anemia. So hemoglobin will decrease, RBC will decrease, retic will decrease. All indices will decrease like iron deficiency anemia. WBC is normal, platelet is normal. So these things are same in both of them. In iron deficiency anemia as well as sideroblastic anemia. Give me a thumbs up. Marrow. Marrow mein cellularity also increases here to compensate. Erythropoiesis increases to compensate. ME ratio decreases to compensate. But marrow iron. In iron deficiency anemia, marrow iron was less. Here it is more. It is more and it is forming type 3 sideroblast, ring sideroblast. Ring sideroblast in the marrow. So this is the difference. Here comes the difference first time. Baki sab abhi tak same hi tha. Here comes the difference. Let me come on the biochemistry. Who will help me in filling biochemistry? Who will help me? What about serum iron? Serum iron will be less or more in sideroblastic anemia. Serum iron will be less or more. It will be normal or it will be little bit on higher side. It will be little bit on higher side because it is not utilized. Na? It will remain in serum only. It will go. Ferritin ka kya hoga? Ferritin will increase here. Ferritin will increase here. Give me a thumbs up. Ferritin will increase here. And TIBC and transferrin saturation, here TIBC will be less and transferrin saturation will be more. TIBC will be less and transferrin saturation. So all the things are reversed here. All the things are reversed. So can you see, this is how you will differentiate the two types of anemia. The best indicator to differentiate between the two is ferritin. No need to learn this. If you understand the pathophysiology of the two types of anemia, you can fill this chart by your own. Everyone give me a thumbs up, I tried hard. Everyone. So I'm skipping the theory. I have told you the summary. You can see the ring sideroblast here. These are the ring sideroblast in the bone marrow in sideroblastic anemia. That is the thing. You got it? Have you got it? What is the problem? The problem in sideroblastic, in iron deficiency anemia, the problem is here. You are taking less iron in the diet, number one. Or the problem is here. The iron you are taking in diet, but it is not absorbed. So this is the problem with IDA. IDA mein problem intestine mein hai. Or problem diet mein hai, in IDA. But in sideroblastic anemia, the problem is in the bone marrow. Bone marrow ke precursors mein, normoblast, early intermediate, late ke andar ka mitochondria ke andar ke aala mein problem. So there is a problem. So abundant of iron is present in the blood, but that cannot be utilized for converting iron into hemoglobin. So all the iron will remain in blood only and it will be accumulated in ferritin. So blood iron is low, more, and ferritin is also more, but hemoglobin is less. Give me a thumbs up. So first time you got it. Yes. So yes, I will come on MCQ. Don't worry. I will directly come on the MCQs. You can see pearl stain here. You can see abundant of iron here. Abundant of iron. Biochemistry means everything is ulta as compared to IDA. Serum iron is more. Ferritin is more. Transferrin saturation is more. And TIBC is normal or less, you can see. So everything is reverse as compared to IDA, as I have told you. Give me a thumbs up. So you can do a differential diagnosis of the SETA. So this was iron deficiency anemia and this is sideroblastic anemia. So compare the two, compare serum iron, here it was reduced, here it is rest. Compare serum ferritin, here it is reduced, here it is rest. Compare marrow iron, here it is absent or reduced, here it is high. Done, here ring sideroblasts are present, here rest is absent. Give me a thumbs up. And MCV, MCH, MCHC, it is reduced in both. Give me a thumbs up. Done. So treatment. What is the treatment? Last thing is treatment. What is the treatment of this sideroblastic anemia? As I have told you, if it is congenital, hereditary, nothing can be done. Now, if it is acquired, if it is due to lead, INH, chloramphenicol, remove the offending agent. If you remove the offending agent, ALAP will be resynthesized and it will be cured by itself. Number one, there is no definite treatment. You can offer blood transfusion for congenital MAR and you can give pyridoxine. It can occur due to pyridoxine deficiency also. So give pyridoxine as a treatment. You can offer vitamin B6 as a treatment. So I am done. I would like to launch polls based on it. You have to give me 1 minute for launching polls on sideroblastic anemia. Then I will move to another anemia, anemia of chronic disease or Mazidar. Okay, so how many polls? Just let me see the answers first. I have to take the answers before you know. Okay, 7 polls are there. So this is the first poll in front of you. So be fast. You have 15 seconds to mark it. Be fast and accurate. So took the clues from the question. A 33-year-old alcoholic on ATT. So patient is having tuberculosis. Patient is on ATT treatment and patient is alcoholic also. So he was having two things. Number one, serum iron is increased. Iron is increased and transferrin saturation is also increased. So which type of anemia he is having? So the anemia in which, so iron deficiency anemia is ruled out. Number one, it is ruled out because serum iron is more and transferrin is more. In iron deficiency anemia, both of them are less. So it is ruled out. So rest of the three options, from rest of the three options, what is the correct answer? What is the correct answer? How you will approach this question? Now in anemia of chronic disease, serum iron will be less, but ferritin will be more. So again, it is also ruled out. Megaloblastic anemia or sideroblastic anemia, both can occur in alcoholic, but ATT is the clue here. Here the clue is ATT. ATT may isoniazid is the drug of choice. Now we give isoniazid. So in ATT, in isoniazid along with alcohol, so they causes deficiency of vitamin B6 and it will lead to sideroblastic anemia. It will temporarily inhibit ALA synthetase and deficiency of ALA synthetase will lead to iron accumulation, inhibition of conversion of iron into hemoglobin. It will lead to sideroblastic anemia. So yes, the answer is sideroblastic anemia. Everyone of us, we know. Okay, you all are right. So Shantanik, Dr. Tarek and Hema are first to answer it correctly. But why the approach should be there? No, I would like to tell you three anemia, Sita, S, I, and T, male erythrocytosis, and A, anemia of chronic disease. This is sideroblastic anemia. This is iron deficiency anemia. Only one thing I would like to tell you here. In these three things, you have to see two things, serum iron and serum ferritin. Who will tell me serum iron and serum ferritin in each of them? Who will tell me? I'm telling you the crux, huh? I'm telling you the crux here. In IDA, what will happen to serum iron and serum ferritin? What will happen to both of them? Tell me one by one. So low in both. So Richard, Shatanip, and Dr. Tarek, you all are right. So both will decrease. What will happen in sideroblastic anemia to both of them? Serum iron and serum ferritin to both of them. You should know the reason also, huh? Why? What will happen to sideroblastic anemia to both of them? Iron and ferritin, both of them will increase. Both of them. Okay. Just now I taught you why both of them are increased. Because patient is eating abundant iron and absorption is no problem. So all the iron will be absorbed and reach in the blood. After blood, it will try to come in the bone marrow, but it is unable to come inside the bone marrow because bone marrow is not accepting the iron. It is unable to convert it into hemoglobin. So all the iron which the patient is eating, absorbed, getting converted into ferritin in the liver. So iron in the blood and ferritin both is increased. What will happen in ACD? ACD serum iron is low, but ferritin is high. So looking at, I will tell you, come on ECD, why it will happen, I will tell you, don't worry. So looking at the two indicators, iron and ferritin, you can decide the three types of anemia. All of them are microcytic hypochromic. Everyone give me a thumbs up. I tried hard. I will come on that. So here the correct answer is B. Okay. The clue was an ATT. ATT and alcoholic. So both of them are causes of hereditary sideroblastic anemia. Done. And the second clue, both things are increasing. You know, serum iron is also increasing, ferritin, transferrin saturation is also increasing. So both of them are increasing. That's why it is sideroblastic anemia. Done. So that is the thing. Okay. This is the next question in front of you. Be fast. Sideroblastic anemia is seen in chronic poisoning of which of the following element? Is it lead, arsenic, copper, and mercury? You all are right, it is lead. I have told you in acquired causes of sideroblastic anemia, it is lead. So Khushi, Richard, and Sweetie are first to answer it correctly. Very good. The correct answer here is lead. Easy question. This is the next question in front of you. Ring sideroblasts are seen in. Okay, it is one of the acquired causes. I forgot to tell you. Let me see who is right. Ring sideroblast means I am asking for sideroblastic anemia only. So one of the acquired causes of sideroblastic anemia. So it is myelodysplastic syndrome is one of the acquired causes. So Dr. Tarek, Shatanip and Vartika are first to answer it correctly. The correct answer here is B. So ring sideroblast hereditary to hota hai acquired is due to leukemias and myelodysplastic syndrome may be hota hai. So that's why it is the correct answer. Coming on the next question, easy one, I guess easy one, big one but easy one. Please read it. What is the pathogenesis of hypochromic anemia and lead poisoning? Why in lead poisoning we have hypochromic anemia? Which hypochromic anemia we have in lead poisoning? We have four hypochromic anemia. Sita. Out of this, which happens in lead poisoning? In lead poisoning, Sita ka S, that is sideroblastic anemia occurs. So that was the first clue in the question ki lead poisoning mein sideroblastic anemia hota hai. Aadhe students ko to yehi nahi pata. Agar ye pata bhi hai, toh what is the cause? What is the cause? The cause is inhibition of enzymes involved in heme biosynthesis of the mitochondria of the precursors of the RBC. So the correct answer here is A. Hema, Shatanip and Yash are first to answer it correctly. Very few students answered it correctly. So correct answer here is A. Have you got it? Those who are wrong, give me a thumbs up. Those who are wrong. Have you got it? Give me a thumbs up. Those who are wrong. So in lead poisoning, pehle to Sita mein se kya hota hai? All of them are hypochromic anemia. So Sita mein se sideroblastic anemia hota hai. Lead poisoning hai. Now what is the cause of sideroblastic anemia? Read the four options. Read the four options. Jan, yes, these are the enzymes. Shatanip, you are right. So I'm not reading it, but yeah, these all are the enzymes you are enumerating. These are the correct. So correct is this. So correct answer here is A. Done. So A is the correct answer. Coming on the next question. Next question is in front of you. Please read the question before marking. A patient presents with increased serum ferritin. Ferritin is increased. Decreased TIBC. TIBC is decreased and increased iron. Increased percentage saturation. Increased saturation and increased iron. Increased iron, most probable diagnosis. Static question, static answer. Specific question, specific answer. So the scenario is fitting only in one. In one, that is sideroblastic anemia. If you say it is iron deficiency anemia, sab kuch ulta hai. Everything is opposite. Iron deficiency anemia mein ye kam, ye kam, ye zyada, ye kam hona chahiye. Everything is opposite. So it is not iron deficiency anemia. In sideroblastic anemia, in sideroblastic, in anemia of chronic disease, iron is less, but ferritin should be more. So again, it is not going with it. In thalassemia minor, aapka percentage saturation or serum iron is fit nahi hoga. So the correct answer here is sideroblastic anemia only, and you all are right. Hema, Ramzan and Khushi are first to answer it correctly. So these questions are confusing in the exam. You should know the biochemistry of each of them. You should know the cause for each of them. So biochemistry apne aap bana loge. So you have to compare like this. Sita, sideroblastic anemia, iron deficiency anemia, and SIT, thalassemia, and inflammation is anemia of chronic disease, ACD, main inflammation hota hai. So Sita tumhare samne hai, the SITA, Sita, you have to compare these indicators, that is serum iron, ferritin, percentage saturation, and TIBC. These four things in each of them. This is a master table, master stroke, I must say. This is a master stroke. You should include this table in your final day revision. So at the last day of your revision, if you revise it and apply it in your clinical question, you will be right in your question. What is increasing, what is decreasing, in which of them? All of them are microcytic hypochromic anemia. So that is the approach. Pehle to microcytic hypochromic mein chari option hai Sita. On Sita may be serum iron, serum ferritin, TIBC or transferrin saturation ka kya hota hai? Kis mein kya increase, kya decrease? Don't mug it up. If you mug it up now, you will never be correct in your exam. Just try to understand why. You should understand four whys in the four scenarios. Give me a thumbs up. Should I proceed? Okay. So this is the next question in front of you. Easy one. Easy one. Very easy. BB question. So lead poisoning is associated with which anemia? So lead poisoning is associated with sideroblastic anemia. Sideroblastic anemia is one of the microcytic hypochromic anemia. So the correct answer here is A. Most of you are right. Yes. Shantanib and Richard are first to answer it correctly. So correct answer here is A. This is the next question in front of you. Okay. So again, acquired causes pe hai. You have to learn the acquired causes. Huh? Hereditary cause to ek hi hai, ALA deficiency. Acquired causes you have to learn. So acquired causes are all except. So collagen vascular disease is the acquired cause. Erythropoietin porphyria is the acquired cause. Lead poisoning is the acquired cause. But cutaneous porphyria is not acquired cause. So you have to see in the acquired cause, rare causes may erythropoietic porphyria is there, but cutaneous porphyria is not there. So you have to learn this table. You have to learn this table. I'm done with iron deficiency anemia. I'm done with sideroblastic anemia. I'm coming on the next anemia, anemia of chronic diseases. So from Sita, I will teach you three today. So I'm done with I. I'm done with S. anemia, iron deficiency anemia, sideroblastic anemia. Now I'm coming on A, ACD, anemia of chronic disease. Thalassemia I will teach you tomorrow. After that, I will take megaloblastic and aplastic. Megaloblastic and aplastic padhenge, thalassemia kal padhenge. Done. So I'm coming on anemia of chronic disease. Again, a master stroke. Why it happens? Why it happens? Anemia of chronic disease, as the name indicates, it is an anemia in any chronic disease. Patient is not having primary problem of anemia. Patient is having some of the chronic disease. Patient is having rheumatoid arthritis. Patient is having tuberculosis. Patient is having some cancer. Patient is having some hematological problems. Patient is having some other chronic disorder. And a patient is having renal failure, acute or chronic renal failure. Because of that, patient is having anemia. So that is the secondary problem. That is anemia of chronic disease. So patient is basically having some anemia developed secondary to a chronic disease. And the anemia is directly related to the disease. Don't treat anemia, treat the disease. Treat chronic disease, anemia will be cured automatically. Anemia will be treated automatically. You have to correct only primary disease. And anemia will be alleviated by itself. Give me a thumbs up if you got it. Give me a thumbs up. Why it happens, I will tell you. So, what is the etiology? You have to learn which chronic diseases. So, among infections, it is TB, lung abscess, pneumonia, osteomyelitis, ABE, SABE, pyelonephritis, in all of them. Among non-infectious diseases, it is RA, rheumatoid arthritis, SLE, Crohn's disease. In disseminated malignancies, it is Hodgkin's lymphoma, it is renal failure. So in all of the diseases, chronic diseases, patient also have anemia. Patient also have anemia. Why? Why? Aisa kya ho raha hai chronic disease mein ki patient ko anemia ho raha hai? In all chronic diseases, there is inflammation. In chronic disease, macrophages got stimulated. Macrophages got stimulated. So macrophage will secrete IL-6. Interferon gamma and TNF alpha, IL-1, IL-6, interferon gamma and TNF alpha. These are pro-inflammatory cytokines. These pro-inflammatory cytokines will do two things. Will do two things. Listen, number one, they decrease erythropoietin from the kidney. Erythropoietin is synthesized from the kidney and they increase hepcidin. Erythropoietin is decreased, hepcidin is increased. I will teach you both. Don't worry. Both of them will lead to anemia. Listen, listen. You know what is erythropoietin? Erythropoietin is a molecule which is synthesized by the kidney. From the kidney, it will come in the blood. It will, this EPO, erythropoietin will come in the blood. From blood, it will go to the bone marrow. These are the precursors in the bone marrow. Can you see in the bone marrow? It is early normoblast, intermediate normoblast, late normoblast. All of them take this erythropoietin from the blood and they got mature, they got proliferate. They will do cell division and RBCs are formed. So erythropoietin is required for cell division, proliferation of the precursors. Which precursors? Erythroid precursors. What is the name of them? Normoblast. Early normoblast, intermediate normoblast, late normoblast. For their cell division, proliferation, we require EPO. So in chronic inflammation due to interferons, interleukin, TNF-alpha, pro-inflammatory cytokines, EPO is decreased. EPO is decreased, so their cell proliferation will decrease. They will not proliferate and RBCs are formed, which are less in number. So that's why patient is having anemia. That is one number reason. Give me a thumbs up. The reason is number one, A. Give me a thumbs up. So decrease erythropoietin. So proliferation of the precursors is decreased. So erythropoiesis will not take place properly. So it will lead to anemia. That is number one reason. This is easy. The second reason is difficult. Increase in hepcidin. You know what is hepcidin? These are the precursors. You know? These are the precursors, early normoblast, intermediate normoblast, late normoblast. For their proliferation, they require EPO. EPO is secreted from the kidney. In the blood, via blood, it is coming here. And if EPO is less, their cell proliferation will not take place and it will not result in formation of RBC and it will result in defective erythropoiesis. It will result in anemia. That is the reason number one. What is hepcidin? What is hepcidin? Yesterday, I taught you what is hepcidin. If I'm eating too much iron in the diet, all the iron will get accumulated here in the liver in the form of the ferritin. So liver will identify that iron is excess in the body. So liver will form a protein. The name of the protein is hepcidin. Can you know? Hepcidin. So this hepcidin will be secreted in the blood. It is the iron regulator. Yes, Yash. So what it is doing actually, it is doing two things. See, hepcidin se maine do iron nikale hain. Hepcidin is going via blood to the ferroportin and it is inhibiting ferroportin. So iron absorption is decreased. Number one. And hepcidin is required for mobilization of iron. Mobilization of iron from liver to bone marrow. If I stop eating iron, so iron mere bone marrow ko kahan se milega? You will say, ma'am, backup hai na, liver se le lo. Thode din jab tak aap nahi kha rahe, liver se le lo. You can take it from the liver. So for mobilization of iron from liver to bone marrow, we require hepcidin. Give me a thumbs up. Now, in chronic inflammation, patient is having chronic inflammation. Due to chronic inflammation, patient is having excess of cytokines in the blood, pro-inflammatory cytokines, interleukins, interleukin-1, 6, TNF, interferon. So all of them are increasing hepcidin, increasing abundant of hepcidin in the blood. So that hepcidin will do two things. Number one, it inhibit ferroportin. So iron absorption will decrease. So blood may iron is less. Blood may iron is less. Number two, it inhibits the mobilization. It is not required for mobilization. It inhibits the mobilization. So excess of hepcidin inhibits the mobilization of iron. So all the iron will be accumulated in the liver. Now tell me two things. Blood iron ka kya hoga aur ferritin ka kya hoga? Dono mein dimag laga ke batana. Man se mat dena. Man se bhakti mat dena. Dimag laga ke batao. Serum iron ka kya hoga? What will happen to serum iron in chronic inflammation? So excess of hepcidin is inhibiting ferroportin. So iron is not absorbed at all. Because ferroportin is inhibited. So blood iron will decrease. Done. What will happen to ferritin? Ferritin is present in the liver. But mobilization of that ferritin into the bone marrow is also blocked. So all the ferritin got accumulated in the liver only. It cannot move to the bone marrow. So ferritin is increased. So blood iron is decreased. Ferritin is increased. Ferritin is more. Still it is unable to reach the bone marrow. And bone marrow is doing defective erythropoiesis. It is forming less RBCs. It is having anemia. Give me a thumbs up. Still the patient is having more ferritin. Still it is not utilized for formation of the formation of hemoglobin. So patient have less hemoglobin, less iron, less hemoglobin. Give me a thumbs up. So here blood iron is less, but ferritin is more. Give me a thumbs up, everyone. That is the problem with iron deficiency anemia. Now compare the three: IDA, sideroblastic anemia, and anemia of chronic disease. And compare the three things here. Two things here. Blood iron, serum iron, and serum ferritin. What will happen to each of them? In IDA, the problem. What is the problem? You are not eating iron. IDA में हमेशा imagine करो iron high नहीं रहे और खा रहे हैं तो absorb नहीं हो रहा. तो iron है ही नहीं. Iron नहीं है तो ferritin भी नहीं है. So both of them are less in IDA. What was happening in sideroblastic anemia? You are eating abundant iron. That all is going in the blood. The problem is with the mitochondria of the precursor. They are unable to convert iron into hemoglobin. So all the iron getting accumulated in the liver in the form of the ferritin. So more iron, more ferritin. What is the problem here in ACD? You tell me. There are two problems. Ek to erythropoietin wala problem hai. Okay, leave it. It was easy. Hepcidin ka kya problem hai? What is the problem with hepcidin? Hepcidin is increasing. So it is doing two things. It is inhibiting ferroportin. So iron absorption is less. So there is less serum iron. But it is also inhibiting the transport of iron from the liver to the bone marrow. So ferritin increases. Now compare the three. Both decreasing in IDA. Both increasing in sideroblastic anemia. Iron is decreasing and ferritin is increasing in ACD. I cannot simplify more than this. I tried best. Give me a thumbs up. Itna samjhane ki baat to everyone should, it should be clear to everyone. Give me a thumbs up now, fast. You should appreciate it. Yes, ma'am, samajh mein aaya, aage chalo. Done, fast, patapat. So have you got it? That is a problem with chronic anemia of chronic disease. So we know the pathogenesis. Clinical features are same. Coming on lab diagnosis directly. Lab diagnosis is same. You know it. Now I'm not filling it. You already know it. Yes or no? So the problem is here. Here the serum iron will be less, but ferritin will be more. That is the problem. Have you got it? Should I proceed? So I'm leaving it. Rest of the things are same. So serum iron is less, ferritin is increased. Give me a thumbs up. TIBC will be normal or decreased. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up so that you can do. So let me tell you the questions based on ACD. We are done with the three types of anemia from the core. Sita mein se teen ho gaye. T chhod ke. T kal padhenge. Bache hue teen ho gaye. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So you have to compare. You have to compare serum iron, ferritin, TIBC, marrow stores for each of them. And comparing that will be your master table. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Should I proceed ahead? What is the treatment? Treat the underlying cause. Treat the chronic inflammation. Don't treat anemia. Treat chronic inflammation. If chronic inflammation is treated, your pro-inflammatory cytokines will reduce. So EPO will increase and hepcidin will decrease. And anemia will be treated automatically. Give me a thumbs up. Treat the cause. Don't treat anemia. Don't give BT to the patient. BT to ke bar bar hota chahega. Kyunki tab tak chronic inflammation body mein rahega, wo repeat hoga. So treat the cause. Treat the underlying cause. Yes, whatever cause it is, you have to treat it. Should I proceed? I would like to learn some polls based on anemia of chronic disease ACD. Only 2-3 polls are there, I guess I'm having here with me. Okay, only 2 are there. Okay, this is the first one. Tricky one, don't rush. Tell me the correct answer. What is the cause of anemia of chronic disease, ACD? Anemia of chronic disease, what is the cause? Is it vitamin B12 deficiency, folate deficiency? No, these are the cause of megaloblastic anemia. Is it chronic blood loss? No, it is a blood loss. No, it is iron deficiency anemia. Is it decreased utilization of the stored iron? Yes. Ferritin cannot be utilized for formation of the hemoglobin in the bone marrow because mobilization is restricted because of excessive hepcidin. So that is the thing. So correct answer here is C. Dr. Tarik Patel and Khushi are first to answer it correctly. Most of you are right. Very good. Correct answer is C. So I hope you got it. So read the question. I'm not launching in the form of the poll. Write your answer in the chat box once you are done. So don't read the option and write the answer. Understand the question. Have your approach. A 60-year-old male, take the clues from the patient. 60-year-old male is there with a history of rheumatoid arthritis. Now RA is a big history here. Patient is having a chronic inflammation, that is rheumatoid arthritis. Presented with hemoglobin 4.5. So a patient with chronic inflammation, that is rheumatoid arthritis, having severe anemia. Hemoglobin is only 4.5. Platelet are normal, 2 lakh. 1.5 to 4 lakh, it is normal. 2 lakh is normal. TLC is also normal, 6,000. 4,000 to 11,000 normal count. It is 6,000. Ferritin, you should know the normal values of these now. Without knowing normal values, you cannot say that tukka hoga ki RA mein. So, tukka nahi maarna hai. You should know exact values. What is normal serum ferritin level? Here, ferritin is increased. And here, iron is decreased. Normal iron, 50 milligrams is zyada hona chahiye. So, iron is decreased, ferritin is increased. So, looking at this scenario, the correct answer here is ACD. So, what are the clues given in the question? Number one, patient is having RA, that is chronic inflammation. Number two, patient is having anemia. Patient is having anemia. Number three, iron is decreased. Number four, ferritin is increased. So, based on these 4 clues, my best answer is A. And most of you are right. Have you got it? What is the approach? So, you should know the normal values. Normal values ki baat nikli hai, to puri learn kar lo. Ek hi baar mein, you have to learn it. So, what is normal hemoglobin level? It is 13 to 17. Normal platelet, 1.5 to 4.5 lakh. Normal TLC, the WBC count, 4,000 to 11,000. Normal ferritin is 15 to 300. Okay, it is 200, you will say. You will say it is 200, ma'am. But, it is within the normal range. Agar bada hua hota to zyada better hai. Normal iron is from 50 to 150 and the patient is having 30. So iron is reduced and ferritin is not increased, it is normal, yet normal. And TIBC is 300 to 400. Please learn these normal range for solving your clinical MCQs. That is my advice to you. Include it in your high-yielding notebook and the last day you should revise it. I am done with this anemia also. Till now we are done with IDA, we are done with sideroblastic, we are done with ACD, anemia of chronic disease. I am coming on the next anemia. Should I first complete aplastic and PERCA? Because if I start megaloblastic, it will not be completed. So just give me 1 minute. I'm coming on aplastic and PERCA. The two small are there. I will launch polls also. Okay, just a second. I'm coming on aplastic and PERCA. So aplastic anemia and PERCA, both of them are due to stem cell disorders. I have to jump there. Okay, so here I am. One more second. Pernicious anemia. Okay. So here I am. So you can see we have completed the cytoplasmic defect. Now nuclear defect. बाद में देखते हैं. Let me come on stem cell. There is a problem in stem cell. So two types of anemia are there. Aplastic anemia and PERCA. Let me talk about aplastic anemia. In aplastic anemia, stem cell is defective. So neither RBC is formed, nor WBC is formed, nor platelet is formed. Patient presents with pancytopenia. So it is very easy. So aplasia of the bone marrow, because hematopoietic stem cell is not working. So patient is having anemia, patient is having leukopenia, patient is having thrombocytopenia. All three counts are less, patient is having pancytopenia. So it is an easy diagnosis. What are the causes? So cause can be congenital. Congenitally, God has not given hematopoietic stem cells properly. So congenital mate is Fanconi's anemia. So congenital aplastic anemia is Fanconi's anemia. Very important for MCQs. And secondary, there are many causes. There can be many drugs, there can be many toxins, there can be many infections which depresses the bone marrow temporarily. If you remove the offending agent, bone marrow, again, it will be survived. Have you got it? So that these are the acquired causes. So in pathogenesis, the stem cell, the hematopoietic stem cell is vanishing here. It is vanishing here. So aplasia of the bone marrow is there. So all three counts are decreased. RBC decreases. So patient present with spotting. WBC decreases. So patient present with infection. And platelet decreases. So patient present with bleeding. Have you got it? So that will result in pancytopenia. That is the pathogenesis. Clinical features I have already taught you. So anemia, thrombocytopenia, leukopenia. Anemia leads to weakness and fatigue. Thrombocytopenia leads to bleeding. And leukopenia leads to infection. So sometimes patient comes with fungal infection in the mouth, thrushes everywhere. So looking at it, we just do a CBC and we found the patient is pancytopenic. Patient is pancytopenic. So what lab work you will do? Blood picture to karenge karenge. Bone marrow is more important. In the blood picture, all three counts will be less. Hemoglobin is less, RBC is less, retic count is less, or it can be zero also. WBC is less, platelet is less. Okay, blood count may go. So if you found any patient with pancytopenia, you have to do bone marrow biopsy. You have to do. It is a rule. It is a rule. If a patient is having pancytopenia, look at the bone marrow. Now there are two options. Bone marrow can be hypocellular and bone marrow can be hypercellular. Hypocellular pancytopenia or hypercellular pancytopenia. So looking at the bone marrow, the causes are different. So bone marrow is also hypocellular, means problem bone marrow mein. Problem bone marrow mein hai. Bone marrow mein problem hai, wahi se cell nahi ban raha, iske blood mein nahi aa raha hai. Aur bone marrow hypercellular hai, matlab problem bone marrow mein nahi hai. Problem is in the blood. After coming in the blood, the cells are dying because of something. And because of compensation, bone marrow is hypercellular. Have you got it? So you should know the differentials. You should know. So do a bone marrow biopsy of this patient. Now, if it is aplastic anemia, bone marrow mein problem hai na, hematopoietic stem cells are absent. Hematopoietic stem cells are absent, so all series is absent. So if you take out bone marrow, nothing will come. It is known as dry tap. It is known as dry. Can you know you from where we take the bone marrow? Now compare, it is known as dry tap. This is normal bone marrow, healthy bone marrow, and it is a bone marrow in aplastic anemia. See the number of cells here, pink color cells, and see the number of cells. Rarely any cells are there. It is known as dry tap. Take the word for your MCQs. Dry tap. Just a second. Give me a second. Yeah. So again, compare the healthy with aplastic anemia. Dry tap. Again, compare the healthy with aplastic anemia. Dry tap. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. So take it as a dry tap word here. Here it is written. Dry tap. So bone marrow is hypocellular here. Here the bone marrow is hypocellular. So aplastic anemia, hypocellular pancytopenia. In aplastic anemia, there is hypocellular pancytopenia. The problem is in the bone marrow. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Everyone, what is the treatment? What is the treatment? So if it is due to secondary some cause, treat the cause. Identify the cause, offending agent. It is some infection, it is some toxin, it is some drug. Remove it. Remove it so that bone marrow should rejuvenate. It should rejuvenate. And give supportive treatment till then. If RBCs are less, give PET cell. If WBCs are less, give the whole blood. If platelets are less, give the platelet supplement. So whatever it is, give supplement, give supportive treatment till that. And if it is congenital, the only treatment is bone marrow transplant. See for the donor. If the donor sibling is present, twin is present, mother, father is present, children are present, and if you found the HLA match, go for the bone marrow transplant, because bone marrow transplant is the only treatment. Done. It is considered in severe cases under 40 years. 40 years is zyada, bone marrow mein apne aap mein chances failure ke zyada hote hain. So that is the decision of the patient. Otherwise, we have marrow stimulating agents also like androgen or immunosuppressive therapy we can also try. So that is okay. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. Pancytopenia with hypocellular marrow is seen in aplastic anemia. As I have seen you, you should ask, ma'am, what are the causes of pancytopenia with hypercellular marrow? Hypo mein to aplastic anemia hai. What are the causes of pancytopenia with hypercellular marrow? These are the causes. These are the causes. You should learn the causes. Yes, Chatanip, you are right. Most of the causes are right. You can see here. It is myelodysplasia, PNH, myelofibrosis, hairy cell leukemia, megaloblastic anemia, bone marrow lymphoma, SLE, hypersplenism, sarcoidosis, alcohol. So in these causes, the problem is not with the bone marrow. Problem is with the blood. So in blood, the cell counts are less. But in bone marrow, due to composition, there are more cells. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. That is the thing. That is the thing. So that was about aplastic anemia. Now I am coming on PARCA. PARCA, pure red cell aplasia. So this is the hematopoietic stem cell. It will form three stem cells from erythroid progenitor RBCs are formed from myeloid progenitor or WBC ka progenitor WBC is formed from megakaryocyte progenitor platelet will be formed. So in aplastic anemia this cell was defective, so nothing was forming. In PARCA this cell is defective, so WBCs are normal, platelet is normal, only RBC is not forming. So patient do not have pancytopenia, patient have only anemia, patient have, that is known as pure red cell aplasia, PARCA. So it is selective failure of production of erythroid elements, but other elements, that is megakaryocytes, that is platelet, and granulocytes, that is WBC. So WBC and platelets are normal, only RBCs are not formed. So here anemia will be normocytic, normochromic, normo wala anemia hoga. Give me a thumbs up. What are the causes? The most important cause, if it is congenital, it is known as Blackman Diamond syndrome. Please learn the name for MCQs. If it is congenital, it is known as Blackman Diamond syndrome, and if it is acquired, yes, Shatan, if you are right. Most common cause is thymoma, and second most common cause is parvovirus B19 infection. Today in micro, I taught you parvovirus B19 infection. Parvovirus. So it will combine with the progenitor P antigen on the surface of the erythroid progenitor and destroy them. So RBC will not form. In children, what it causes? Name the disease. Those who are old students who have attended my micro lecture today. Name the disease in children caused by parvovirus. Name the disease. Write it down. Slat cheek. Yes, Dr. Tariq. Slat cheek. Or fifth disease, also known as fifth. Yes, Richard, you are right. So in adults, it is causing this, or in fetus, it is causing PARCA. So that is thymoma and PARCA. And in congenital, it is known as Blackman Diamond syndrome. So these are the causes. So till now, let me see if I'm having polls on that. Let me see. I don't guess. Okay, I'm having. Okay, let me see. Okay. So this is the first question in front of you. Few questions are there. Be fast. So aplastic anemia can progress to all of the following except. So I forgot to tell you there, it is written in my notes also. Aplastic anemia can progress to AML, it can progress to myelodysplastic anemia, and it can progress to PNH also, but it cannot progress to PARCA. PARCA is something separate from aplastic anemia. So correct answer here is PARCA. Done. It is PARCA. This is the next question in front of you. Very easy. Everyone will be right. So pure red cell aplasia, PARCA is associated with the acquired cause for PARCA. Acquired. I have told you two acquired causes for PARCA. One is thymoma, other is parvovirus B19 infection. So thymoma, please learn thymoma. Thymoma is the correct answer. If you find any patient with PARCA, screen for thymoma. Patient may have thymoma, or vice versa. If you find any patient for thymoma, screen for PARCA. So both of them are highly associated. So correct answer here is A, Dr. Tariq. Shantanib and Khushi. Sometimes we come to the diagnosis by this way. Incidental finding can be there. So correct answer here is A. This is the next question in front of you. Again the same question, I guess. So an adult who develops PARCA should be evaluated for which of the following? So this usually we do. A patient is coming to me. I'm a hematologist. I found the patient to be PARCA. I will ask the patient to do a thorax mediastinal CT scan. In the mediastinum, I want to see whether the patient is having thymoma or not, because the both of them are highly associated. Incidental finding can be the thymoma. I will ask the patient to get it operated. Done. So it can be the incidental finding. So the correct answer here is D. Khushi, Hema and Shatanib are first to answer it correctly. Very good. So that is the thing here. So I think I am done with iron deficiency anemia, sideroblastic anemia, anemia of chronic disease, aplastic anemia, PARCA, megaloblastic anemia still remaining, and all hemolytic anemias are remaining. I will not take megaloblastic anemia first tomorrow. Tomorrow I will start with hemolytic anemias because again it will remain. So in 1 hour, I will teach you 7 important hemolytic anemias. You know the names. I will make you comparative table, autoimmune hemolytic anemia, hereditary spherocytosis, G6PD deficiency, you know them. So one by one, we will take all 7, sickle cell anemia, thalassemia, we will compare them, the main pathogenesis of each of them and main morphology on which MCQs are asked on each of them. So let me announce tomorrow's timing, then you people can leave. Done. Just a second. Just give me 1 second. Okay. So here I'm ending this lecture. So tomorrow we are having a lecture. Thank you so much for being with me. Next class is tomorrow. Today there is no class in the afternoon. In the afternoon, there is a class for plus students, but it is not a free class. 4:30 to 6:30, I'm having a class for those who are plus students. They can join me for respiratory pathology today evening 4:30 onwards. And today we will study the remaining COPDs, asthma and lung tumors. And tomorrow we are having again 3 classes in the morning. So tomorrow is Wednesday. Yes, right. So tomorrow 9 a.m., 10 a.m. and 11 a.m. Sorry, 10:15 and 11:30. So 3 classes tomorrow I am having. I'm halting the schedule. Tomorrow Wednesday I take usually some special topics, not the routine topics, on every Wednesday. So on last Wednesday I discussed PYQs. This Wednesday I'm taking IBQ marathon. So there is a 3-hour IBQ marathon specially for FMG aspirants. So only IBQs, spotters, sir, image, answer, and little bit explanation, not a detailed one. So more than 300 IBQs I'm going to discuss tomorrow. So don't dare to miss tomorrow 3 classes, 9 a.m., 10:15 a.m., 11:30 a.m. So 9 a.m. till 12:30 a.m. we will be having 3-hour session IBQ marathon. So topic will be from pathology. It will be mixed bag, the entire pathology. I will try to cover entire hematology also, general pathology also, and systemic pathology also. So try to cover in systemic pathology, it will be system wise. So one by one, we will take the important 7 systems, you know, CVS, CNS, respi, breast, and one by one, we will take the systems. General pathology, necrosis or any pe thode bahut jo hai, image bhi bahut zyada nahi hai general pe. Hematology, yeah, all leukemias, all anemias. So IBQs will be there tomorrow, 3-hour session in the morning. Don't dare to miss it, and please ask your friends, colleagues, everyone to attend it. So it is FMG students specially for them. I'm launching this session on a great request, great demand by the students. All of them will be the free classes, special classes tomorrow. So please attend it. That is my humble request to all of you. And just a second, please follow my profile link on an academy if you are not yet followed. So search my name is Dr. Priyanka Sachdev under educators. You will find my name, you will find my profile link, follow it. You will get notifications of all my free classes. And please learn, my code is Sachdev10. If you use this code to unlock the free classes, please distribute without hesitation to this code to all of your friends, colleagues, seniors, juniors, so they can unlock the free classes. On Plus platform, we have 2 platforms, Plus and Iconic. In Plus, you will get an Academy lectures, Iconic, along with an Academy, you will get PrepRadar also. And, you know, these are the batches which are currently available on the Plus platform. These are the offers for you. If you take a subscription for 12 months, you will get 2 months extra. If you take a subscription for 24 months, you will get 4 months extra. And these are the prices for the subscriptions for Iconic and for Plus. Lowest subscription, 1-month subscription is available. Longest subscription is 4 years. So whether you go for 1 month, whether you go for 4 years, it's your wish. Longer the subscription, cheaper it is. So if you are a first prof or second prof student, I advise you to take a longer subscription. It is very cheaper if you see, and it's still on it. If you apply my code, you will get additional discount. The code is Sachdev10. If you apply it, you will get 10% discount additional on this price also, whatever subscription you are planning. So the summary is that code is useful for all students, those who want to watch free classes and those who want to take the subscription. Those who want to watch free classes only, they can unlock my free classes using this code. So please distribute this code on your batch groups, on your seniors, juniors, everyone, so everyone can unlock my class to all the medicos you know all over the world. Please distribute this code for unlocking free classes. And if someone among you or your friends want to take the paid subscription, either Plus or Iconic, please use the same code for getting maximum discount. You will get 10% discount, authentic discount on the hand if you use this code. So please don't hesitate to use this code and join me tomorrow morning, Wednesday special 9 a.m. IBQ marathon, pathology marathon, the complete pathology in one shot. All IBQs in one shot. 3-hour IBQ marathon. Don't dare to miss it. Don't dare to miss it. See you. Bye-bye tomorrow morning, 9 a.m. for free class, and for Plus subscribers, it is today evening, 4:30 to 6:30. Bye-bye. I'm ending the session.